हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू पेंडुलम रेडियो। टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग डेली करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ 3 जून 2020। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द सेशन। फर्स्ट न्यूज इज सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट लॉन्च पीएम स्वनिधि योजना। रिसेंटली द स्कीम प्रधानमंत्री स्ट्रीट वेंडर आत्मनिर्भर निधि दैट इज पीएम स्वनिधि योजना हैज़ बीन लॉन्च्ड एंड दिस स्कीम इज इंटेंडेड टू हेल्प रिवाइवल ऑफ द बिजनेस ऑफ स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स विच वर क्लोज ड्यू टू COVID-19 बाय प्रोवाइडिंग देम स्पेशल माइक्रो लोन facility. The period of the scheme is till March 2022 and this is important. The scheme aims to benefit the 5 million urban businessmen who used to do the same before March 24 this year, and for the first time the street vendors from semi-urban or rural areas have been brought under the urban livelihood program. So this is an important part. Also through this scheme such businessmen that is street vendors, they can avail a working capital loan of up to ₹10,000 for which they can repay in installments within a year, and if the individuals pay the debt on time they will not only be entitled to interest subvention of 7% but also they'll get another loan of ₹20,000 or more in future. Now let's see the question related to this. First, what is not true in relation to PM Swanidhi Yojana? The objective of this scheme is to provide special micro loan facility to street vendors. This is correct. The duration of the scheme is till March 2025. This is wrong because its duration is till March 2025. 22. Under this scheme, street vendors can take a working capital loan of up to ₹10,000. This statement is also correct. For the first time, street vendors from semi-urban or rural areas have been brought under the urban livelihood program, and this statement is also correct. So answer is option B. Moving to the next news, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the Champions Portal in New Delhi. This technology-based solution, Champions Platform, it aims to provide all the solutions in one place for all micro, small and medium enterprises in the country, that is MSME sector. On this platform, complaints related to MSME sector with finance, raw materials and all kind of permission will also be resolved on the same platform. This platform will prove to be helpful in increasing production by strengthening the MSME sector. Now let's see the question related to it. The recently launched Champions platform is related to farmer and agriculture, micro, small and medium enterprises, students and education, migrant labors. So the correct answer is option B, that Champions portal is related to micro, small and medium enterprises. Now let's see the next news. Government announced increase in MSP of 14 Kharif crops. So recently government has announced that minimum support price of 14 Kharif crops will be increased up to 83%, and this will enable the farmers to get better price for their crop. The government has raised the MSP of paddy by rupees 53 per quintal to rupees 1868 per quintal, with 1868 per quintal. It has been decided to increase the minimum support price of cotton by rupees 260 to rupees 5515 per quintal. In addition, the government has extended the short term loan repayment date to August for agriculture and allied related activities. This decision will provide relief to those farmers who had to repay their loans between March 1 and August 31, 2020. Now talking about what is this minimum support price, it is a price which at which the government procure or buy crops from directly from the farmer when the market price fall below this minimum support price. It is a guaranteed price for the produce of the farmer by the government, and the MSP is announced by the government at the beginning. This is important that it is announced at the beginning of the sowing season for some crops based on the recommendations of the Commission for Agriculture Costs and Prices. So question can also be asked that who decides the minimum support price, or based on the recommendation of which commission or committee this MSP is announced. So you have to remember that. The main objective is to get the farmers out of the crisis and purchase food grains for public distribution. Now let's see the question related to it. Recently the government has increased the minimum support price of paddy by rupees 53 per quintal to rupees 1868 per quintal, 2868 per quintal, 3,868 per quintal, 4,868 per quintal. So the correct answer is option A, that is 1,868 per quintal. Now let's see the next news. DRDO developed a disinfection unit called Ultra Swachh. Recently, DRDO has developed a disinfection unit which is named Ultra Swachh, and it can disinfect personal protective equipment, PPE, electronic items including clothes and many other materials. It is available in two variants, ozonated space and Trinetra technology. This unit has been developed by DRDO's Delhi-based laboratory, Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Sciences, in association with Jailcraft Healthcare Private Limited. The system conforms to international norms of industrial, commercial, personal and environmental protection. It involves the use of ozone-based space technology to eliminate infection through sophisticated oxidation process. Now let's see the question. Recently, which institution has developed a disinfection unit called Ultra Swachh? And the options are CSIR, ICMR, DRDO and NIV. So the correct answer is option C, that DRDO has developed a disinfection unit called Ultra Swachh. Now let's move to the next news. Gujarat is prepared to deal with Cyclone Nisarga. Recently, Gujarat administration is ready to deal with Cyclone Nisarga coming in Arabian Sea. The storm is likely to hit the South Gujarat coast by June 3, and 10 teams of NDRF and 5 teams of SDRF have been deployed in the coastal districts of southern Gujarat. Talking about tropical cyclone, a cyclone is a low pressure system with very high winds around it, and the conditions required for tropical cyclones are sufficiently warm sea surface, that is more than 26 degree centigrade, and atmospheric instability required, high humidity is required, and also sufficient Coriolis force is required to maintain a low pressure center. So these are the essential requirements of for a tropical cyclone. The name Nisarga for this cyclone is suggested by Bangladesh. So let's see the question related to it. Cyclone Nisarga can affect which state of India? Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat and Odisha. So the correct answer is option C, that is Gujarat. And recently Cyclone Amphan, it hit the coast of Odisha and West Bengal and caused so much of destruction. And now the Cyclone Nisarga, it's likely to hit Gujarat and Maharashtra coast, and therefore the alerts have been raised in these regions. Now let's see the next news. Online portal Skill Register launched in Himachal Pradesh. So recently an online portal Skill Register was launched in Himachal Pradesh, and this portal will create an efficient database of migrants entering the state during lockdown in the wake of coronavirus pandemic. The Skill Register will help in providing information about the skilled manpower to the industries. Interested persons can register on this online portal. Himachal Pradesh, it is a North Indian state. Its governor is Bandare Dattatreya and the chief minister is Jairam Thakur. Its capitals are Shimla for summer and Dharamshala for winter. Over here in the map, you can see the location of Himachal Pradesh. Now let's see the question related to this news. Recently, online portal Skill Register has been launched by state. Which state? Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. So the correct answer is option A, that is Himachal Pradesh. Now let's move to the next news. Three more states covered under One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. Recently, Odisha, Sikkim and Mizoram have been included under One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. And under this, ration card holders under the National Food Security Act will be able to get their quota ration available at affordable prices from any government shop across the country. Presently, this facility has become available in 17 state and union territories, and the efforts have been made to extend this scheme to other states and for all those consumers to take advantage of their ration card in any state as well. So it is very beneficial for all those migrants which go out for in search of job and live outside of their home state, and but they are unable to avail of this facility under the National Food Security Act to get the ration under this act. So this scheme, One Nation, One Ration Card scheme, it will provide an ease, it will provide a facility to all those which have a single ration card and they can avail all the ration card of their quota from any shop in the country. By 21st March 2021, all states will be included in One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. One Nation, One Ration Card scheme has been launched with the object of enabling poor migrant workers to buy subsidized rice and wheat from any government shop in the country. So this is an important scheme and this is an important initiative of the government, and we have to remember this. Moving to the question, which states have been recently included under One Nation, One Ration Card scheme? Options are Odisha, Sikkim, Mizoram and all of the above. So the correct answer is all of the above. Odisha, Sikkim and Mizoram have been recently included under One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. Now let's see the next news. Uttar Pradesh is the first state in the country to produce 1 lakh beds for treatment of COVID-19. Recently, Uttar Pradesh has become the first state in the country to produce 1 lakh beds for COVID-19 patients. And in this, dedicated beds are available for patients with respective facilities in every 75 districts. Here, beds in hospitals have been classified into three categories, level 1, level 2 and level 3. Level 1 and level 2 beds are for the patients which are showing mild symptoms, while level 3 beds are for critically infected people. Talking about Uttar Pradesh, it is the most populous state in India. Its capital is Lucknow. Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath. Governor is Anandiben Patel. The state animal of Uttar Pradesh is swamp deer. Its state bird is Saras crane. State tree is Ashok and state flower is Brahma Kamal. Uttar Pradesh has 80 seats in the Lok Sabha, 31 seats in Rajya Sabha and 403 assembly seats. Now let's see the question. Recently, which state became the first state in the country to produce 1 lakh beds for COVID-19 patients? And the options are Kerala, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. So the correct answer is option C, that is Uttar Pradesh. Moving to the next news, Election Commission announced the election date for remaining seats of Rajya Sabha. Recently, Election Commission has announced election date for remaining 18 seats of Rajya Sabha, for which voting will be held on June 19, 2020. And these elections will be held in Andhra Pradesh, Jharkhand, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Manipur, Meghalaya and Rajasthan. Talking about Rajya Sabha, it is a permanent body. It is not subjected to dissolution. However, 1/3 of its members retire every second year and newly elected members are appointed in their place. Also, Rajya Sabha consists of a maximum of 250 members, of which 238 members represent states and union territories and 12 members are nominated by the president. Each member is elected for a term of 6 years. The president of India is the ex officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Now let's see the question related to this. How many members of Rajya Sabha retire every other year? 2/3, 1/4, 1/3 or half? So the correct answer is option C, that 1/3 of members retire every second year in Rajya Sabha. Now let's see the next news. June 2, Telangana Foundation Day. Telangana Foundation Day is observed every year on 2nd June. This year, that is in 2020, it marks the 6th anniversary of the state. The state came into existence officially as the 29th state of India on 2 June 2014, seceding from Andhra Pradesh. But at present, since the removal of Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir, there are 28 states and 9 union territories in the country. K. Chandrasekhar Rao was elected the first chief minister of state after the elections. Talking about Telangana, it is a state in southern India. Its capital is Hyderabad. Its governor is Tamilisai Sundara Rajan and its chief minister is K. Chandrasekhar Rao. Telangana has 17 seats in the Lok Sabha and 119 assembly seats. Now let's see the question related to the news. Telangana came into existence as a state in which year? 2015, 2016, 2014 and 2017. So the correct answer is option C, that is 2014. 14. So friends, here we have comprehensively covered daily current affairs of 3rd June. You can also read this daily current affairs and download PDF from our website pendulumedu.com. And also these current affairs are available in Hindi also. So you can also refer that. So and recently SSC has also announced the rescheduled dates of CHSL and JE exam. So now friends, you have to be prepared for your upcoming exam. So keep following us, keep preparing with us, subscribe to our channel Pendulum Edu, and do not forget to press the bell icon to receive notification. Thank you so much.